Good morning, children.
Children,
today in this video, we will discuss about the economic importance of artificial propagation. Along with this, we will study about the advantages and disadvantages of vegetative propagation. Let's start with economic importance of artificial propagation. Artificial propagation is a method in which we increase the number of plants by processes like grafting, layering, stem cutting, and tissue culture. So these methods are commonly used in horticulture and agriculture. Horticulture is an art of cultivating plants. We cultivate food plants also and the plants for decorative purposes. In agriculture, we grow crops. Along with that, animal rearing also comes under agriculture. So children, artificial propagation is commonly used in horticulture and agriculture. From artificial propagation, high yielding and disease resistant varieties of fruit trees can also be formed. Why? Because in artificial propagation, we select the plants, we take the desired characters and then we develop the plants. Therefore, this is helpful in developing high yielding and disease resistant varieties of fruit trees. By tissue culture method, thousands of plants can be grown. And because we are selecting the plants, these plants are grown free from infections. So that's all about the economic importance of artificial propagation. Let's start with advantages of vegetative propagation. Children, as compared to sexual reproduction, vegetative propagation is a rapid, easier, and cheaper method. Why? Because in sexual reproduction, seed formation occurs and it takes a lot of time for a seed to grow and develop into a new plant. Therefore, vegetative propagation is considered as an easier method. Now, new plants produced by vegetative propagation are the exact copies of the parent plants. Plants grown vegetatively usually needs less attention at early stages. And the plants which do not produce the viable seeds, the live seeds, can only be grown vegetatively. They can only be grown vegetatively. So that's all about the advantages of vegetative propagation. Now moving on to the disadvantages of vegetative propagation. Because the plants produced by this method are genetically identical, so therefore there are more chances of getting infected with a disease. Suppose we are producing a new plant by vegetative propagation and the plant which we have selected is diseased, then the new plants produced will also be infected from the same disease. The second point is overcrowding may occur because plants grow in the same area as there is no dispersal of plants. Children, in vegetative propagation, usually in natural vegetative propagation, new plants grow in the same area, in the vicinity. Therefore, overcrowding occurs. And because there is no dispersal of plants. So that's all about the vegetative propagation advantages and disadvantages. And also we have studied about the economic importance of artificial propagation. Thank you.